We are your friends.
Location at the W Hotel to film a very special episode for our spotlight series for edopeno.com. Today we're going to be sitting down with DJs Panic City and Miles Medina, also known as the dynamic party rockin' duo, Your Friends. Today you're also going to be in for a very, very special treat as we get an exclusive all-access look for the Mint Party, which is the hottest pool party this side of town, brought to you by Heavy Arsenal and Hometown Heroes. We have a lot in store for you guys today, so sit back and let's go. Well, first of all, thank you guys for taking the time to be here. I mean, to sit down with us and do this interview. I mean, I know this is a big event for you guys and everything, and I know we've been trying to get together for the past, I don't know, since like
eight, forever.
Dude, forever and
forever.
Ever, but thank you, first
Glad
of all.
To be here.
So,
Glad to be here.
Let's get to it. I just want to find out just a little background information about you guys. I mean, where are you from? Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Well, we're basically from the Bay Area. Mm-hmm. I'm from this place called Union City, a little town between San Francisco and San Jose.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm from the next city over, Fremont.
Uh-huh.
Nothing exciting.
nothing exciting.
Fremont and Union City. So you grew up basically here in the Bay Area.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Yeah. So how did both of you guys meet? How did you guys get together?
Actually, you know, I used to work. Well, I do work with one of a promoter. His name is Vic.
Uh-huh.
He's our friend, and he asked us to do this Halloween. I got this message on Facebook.
Uh-huh.
And he asked us to do a Halloween party together. And he's like, have you heard of Miles Medina? I'm like, yeah, I know that guy.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, I heard him on the radio. And I was like, yeah, let's do it. So we did this Halloween party together.
Yeah. And I really don't remember anything from that night. We were, like, really drunk, you know. But I do remember us being like, hey, you know, we didn't really do anything tonight because we were really drunk. But we should get together. And,
uh-huh.
you know, we hit it off, like, as people more than anything. So.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, people more than DJs. So... I had this residency at this club called Row,
uh-huh.
and I invited him to do a 2x4 because I would always have guests. And I don't know, that night was just so crazy. I was like, man, we gotta start something.
Yeah.
And I mean, the rest is history.
Miles, how long have you been DJing?
I really don't know. Since I was a kid, you know,
uh-huh.
since I was like maybe 11 or 12.
Uh-huh.
But I didn't really get turntables right away because I was a little kid.
Mm-hmm.
You know, parents don't really want to buy their kids turntables.
Right.
Yeah, I've been into it since I was a kid, so.
Cool. And you, Nick?
I started off, you know, I always, like, had a big love for music. So I always produced stuff, and I made beats, like, hip-hop beats and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, from there, I was like, you know what? I'm going to try this DJing thing.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, I just started doing these club gigs, these little club gigs, and they just got bigger and bigger, and it just steamrolled into what it is now, you know? So it worked out.
Yeah. Miles, what made you want to actually start DJing? What sparked your interest?
Just always listening to the radio, hearing DJs. And
uh-huh.
One time I was at a Jordan McKnight concert.
Mm-hmm.
Or it wasn't his concert, but he played at a festival. And he let his DJ shine for like 5 minutes. And he was like killing it. And the crowd was just like, oh my God.
Uh-huh.
And I was like in the back, like just short. Like, yeah, it was nice.
So what's the premise behind forming the duo, Your Friends? I mean, I know separately you guys have your own, you do your own thing, you rock crowds on your own, but what's the motivation behind, you know, starting to perform together?
So,
I mean, you know, me and Nick, we just, you know, our styles are like very similar but very different. Very, like, different styles but like kind of same taste in music. So together we kind of just it's like pretty much what I lack in, Nick really makes up for, and vice versa. So,
yeah,
you know, it's really that whole thing.
Do you find that it's harder to perform together or separately?
You know, honestly, sometimes I prefer just playing with Miles, you know what I mean? Because I feel like it's a different energy when we play together. So, I mean, it's hard not when I play separately by myself, sometimes I'm like, I want to ask Miles something right now. What would he play? You know what I mean? And, you know, so I do like playing with, I like doing the Your Friends thing. I mean, it's really exciting, you know, and it's doing really well right now. So, yeah.
So you guys basically like feed off each other.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
I mean,
yeah.
I've been to a couple of the events that you guys have performed at, and it's crazy. I mean, what? How much preparation goes into a set? I mean, how much do you guys prepare? Do you just show up and be like, here we go, this is what we're gonna do?
That's exactly what we do. I mean, the funny thing is, like, when we first started, he would come to my house, and we, you know, we were prepared. And now, like, I sometimes only see this guy when we perform, you know. And so we just go off, and you know, yeah, we just have fun, and I guess that's the whole thing behind it.
Is this something that you guys wanted to do when you were growing up and when you were younger?
Like, as far as DJing?
As far as DJing, yeah.
You mean be like a club DJ and everything? Not at all. That was never my intent, you know. It really just came out of nowhere for me. Like, I was working at a record store, and I used to just play records. And someone, like, he's like, hey, can you play at this club? I was like, yeah, sure. And from there, it just really took off. So I didn't plan this at all.
And you, Nick? What did you want to be when you were growing up?
That's funny. You know what? I always wanted to do something in music. And the funny thing is, like, I used to rap and I wanted to be a rapper. And then I kind of just faced it and I was like, you know what, man? Like, you know, I can't do it because I could never perform on stage. You know what I mean? Like, on the mic and stuff like that. So once I started this DJing thing, I mean, I'm like, you know what? I think this is going to work out. And I quit my job and, like, you know, just feeling really good right now.
So this is what you do full time?
Full time.
Awesome. That's super cool. Can you guys tell me about some of the challenges working in this industry? I mean, some of the challenges that you guys have faced?
Go ahead.
You know, there's a bunch of challenges. You know, it's very political. There's a lot of politics involved. There's so much competition. You know, San Francisco, like, we have so many talented people out there. So, you know, but at the same time, it works for the better because, you know, we do have to really step our game up in San Francisco, and it's just, it's good, you know. The challenges are, they make us stronger, if anything.
Was there ever a time that you guys just wanted to quit, or just say, I'm done? Probably not yet.
You know, I haven't got to that point yet.
Yeah.
I really haven't. But, you know, who knows what goals, you know, we're going to have in the future, because, like, me and Miles, we're starting to produce, and, you know, we produce stuff separately and stuff like that, and who knows? What if we just start producing stuff? And, like, I think my main goal is to get us, like, into, like, festivals, you know what I mean? Where we do big shows and play our own stuff, like, what we really want.
Yeah.
You know? So, who knows?
What motivates you guys to keep going and just go for it?
You know, for me, like, one of the things is, well, I do love it. I really do. And then another thing is, I don't know if I could do another 9-to-5. Like, I was always so miserable. And now it's like, I wake up, I listen to music, I make music,
totally.
I just create, you know?
It's something you love.
Right.
What about you, Miles? What motivates you?
What motivates me? You know, like, answering, like, your two past questions, like, I used to want to quit, like, 3 times a year. Just like, oh, you know, I hate this.
Yeah.
But then it just, I keep coming back to it just because, you know, like, all the energy, like, all the love from people. And, you know, I really love doing this. Like, I really can't do anything else. Like, I for sure couldn't get another job if I even tried to. You know?
Like, I would love to do what you guys do.
we're very blessed.
And, I mean, to expand on that, honestly, like, there's so many people who support us. And it's just crazy. Like, you know, after a night's done and all the people giving us, like, really good feedback and so much love from everybody. Like, you know, I don't want to let anyone down. Like, I want to take this as far as I can go.
That's, like, the main thing that really motivates us.
There's so much energy here. I just want to take a second to talk about some of the projects that you guys have done. I mean, Less Than Three. Can you guys talk about a little bit about that? I was listening to that earlier today just to get me hyped up for this party and for this interview.
Less Than Three. Well, I guess I could start our CD beforehand. Uh-huh. We were like, let's make something, let's make like a club CD. Mm-hmm. You know, because that was our first CD ever.
Yeah.
What was it called? Oh, yeah, We Are.
We Are.
It was We Are. It was when we first made Your Friends.
Mm-hmm.
And we wanted to just be ourselves, though, you know what I mean? And keep that intact and not just make a fist pump CD.
Mm-hmm.
And then this next CD, we were like, you know what, man, let's like, I don't know, we have this different kind of energy with Your Friends. And the CD to me was like, I don't know, maybe emotionally charged,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
If you listen to the music.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know, I guess that was the premise behind that.
Okay. What about Tribute? That was your collaboration with Les.
With Les, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Les, very fantastic DJ, check him out. Yeah, he's our buddy. And it's funny because we were at an airport
uh-huh.
going to North Carolina. We all had a gig there.
Mm-hmm.
And I passed by this Chandron store, and I was like, damn, Diddy's everywhere. And I'm like, I should be P. City, like as in P. Diddy.
Okay.
And then Les, if you know Les, he has like this crazy love for Kanye, Kanye West. So I'm like, you should be Kanye Les. And then I'm like, what about Miles? And then I was just thinking Miles Jackson,
mm-hmm.
Michael Jackson.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, we should do this. And it was just a joke. And then
It was a joke.
And then you just went in the studio and just went with it?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah. It was like a joke until Les told us he finished it. You know?
Oh, okay.
Like, like me and him were like, oh, we're not going to do it. And Les was like, dude, I finished ours. Let's put it out. Yeah, so.
Okay. Who would you say are some of your musical influences? I mean, there's probably a lot, but.
Yeah. I could say off the top, DJing-wise, it was, I think, DJ AM.
Uh-huh.
Like, that was the first time. I mean, there's always been, like, Q-Bert, and I've always, you know, watched, like, a lot of scratching videos and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
But then, like, I was just into hip-hop as a whole,
yeah.
and I was rapping then.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, when I seen DJ AM, and I saw, like, the broad amount of music that he played,
mm-hmm.
you know, it was so diverse, I was like, wow, if you could do that and people would like it, like, I didn't know that. You know, mm-hmm. I thought people just played hip-hop or people played techno, you know what I mean? And when he brought it all together and he made it this whole big celebrity thing and I saw the lines, I was like, man, that's crazy. And it really inspired me,
mm-hmm.
me personally.
Yeah. AM for sure, yeah. But you know, for me, like music, I like DJing, I really like get inspiration from like artists, like music artists, and try to incorporate it into my DJing. It's really weird to say, but like, you know, like I like James Brown a lot because he's like very like, I like artists where you can tell they're really into it.
Yeah.
So I really like James Brown and stuff. And, just guys like that where you can tell really love it and just do it for that.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I try to take that and incorporate it to what I do on Thursday. So that's really
So I'm sure you guys are ready to rock this party right now, but before we go, I just want to ask each of you, like, what's your message to the world, like Miles? What do you want to tell everybody out there?
I just want to spread love, you know, through music and just, you know, pretty much, you know, there's like people like that really are into like violence and war, and like I really see no point for that. Like, would you rather like go kill someone or go dance to like some great song, you know?
I
want
to go dance.
Wow, that's a great answer.
What's your answer, Nick? Come on.
Honestly, I'm just very thankful for everybody who like supports us,
mm-hmm.
has our backs. Actually, big shout out to my boy Will, who's had our back. He's actually the one who's bringing us to this party. And he's the best roommate ever. So, Will, he's the man behind this right now.
Will.
So. Appreciate you, dude.
Well, there you have it, guys. Check out Miles and Panic City. They're about to rock this party right now, so I don't want to hold them up over here. Can you tell everybody where to find you on your website?
Twitter.com/WeAreYourFriends.
There you go.
Yeah, so.
And on their respective websites?
DJPanicCity.com.
MilesPanicCity.com. And soon-to-be-YourFriends.com, I think.
Yeah, I think it's YourFriends.com or WeAreYourFriends. We're working on it, so, yeah.
There you have it.
Check
thank
it out.
Thank you again, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you,
appreciate
guys.
It.
I feel so close to you right now, it's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love bars down on me, surround me like